We're back again. It came today, like I said in my previous video. Actually, both of them came, so I was like, alright. So I didn't have to... Which I was planning on waiting until I got both before I did another video anyways. But they both came today, so yay. This one here... That's the wool cap. And it's... Same quality wool as, you know... As the actual, you know, authentic Japanese wool cap. It's got the flaps in the back. My lighting's not as good today because it's not beautiful blue sky outside. And instead, it's nasty, rainy, and... Which we don't really need, but yeah, it rains here quite a bit. And again, this comes from World War Supply. This is a reproduction, too. I wouldn't want to, you know, if I'm going to use it, I wouldn't want an authentic one anyways. And then over here is the ammo belt. Let's see if I can get a... It's got three. Those are ammo pouches. And this one's for a Type 38. They do have a Type 99 belt, but it's pretty much the same. The stitching and stuff's a little different. That's about it. And maybe the belt buckle's a little different. This has a brass belt buckle. This is your frog for your bayonet, which I was getting ready to demonstrate that. And it's tight, and it's supposed to be real tight, so when you go to, see, so when you go, when you're wearing this, when you pull it out, the blade comes out, instead of the whole, you know, scabbard, so it's supposed to fit tight in there for a reason. Pretty nice. I don't have no ammo in here yet. I did have this on earlier and stuff. I tried it all on, and it's surprisingly it's a little bit loose, even all the way down to the very last belt hole. If anything, I might have to punch another hole. So I'm like, yeah, I guess I am really, really super thin because this thing's a little loose on me. But I took pictures, and that's mainly for. Another website that I post stuff on, which of course I'll add that to the video. But yeah, this is nice, and my whole apartment smells like leather, because this is, you know, genuine leather. It's not like cheap material or nothing. That's why this was $70, but I didn't pay that because World War Supply marked it down and gave me a special offer to get it for $40, and I thought that was a steal. That's why I jumped on it. I think I only had like 4 hours to accept his offer, you know, because the offers are limited. So I bought it. But yeah, they're nice. I haven't opened these or anything yet. I guess I could go ahead. That's pretty stiff, but that's how leather is. There we go. Which way does it? No, opens from this way, okay. But as you see, there's nothing in there, but yeah, you put your stripper clips of ammo in here. That's what it's for. And even though this is a Type 38 belt, you can still have stripper clips for either 6.5 or 7.7 Japanese. It'll hold that. And I'm sure if... Say, you know, you're not into those firearms or whatever, or you're not even into this, you could put different ammo in it too. Like, you could put your 30-06 in it. That's not why I got this, though. I got it because, you know, I'm into the Japanese stuff, obviously. I'll fix with that later. But, yeah. It's not going to be a very long video this time. You've already seen the helmet. I really like this wool cap, though. But after you put everything on, man, after, you know, just imagine being out in the Pacific Theater wearing this stuff where it was extremely humid out. So, I mean, that's probably why they were too, where they were so skinny, because as soon as I put all the gear and stuff on, plus the helmet over on top of this, I mean, I was sweating. So imagine being out where it's, 100 degrees and you're fighting and you got all this stuff and equipment on. Just amazes me. But yeah, that's the end of this video, and again, have a good day. It's gonna be blue.